every service station in Arizona is required to register their underground storage tanks with DEQ and also to have a working leak detection system. If that leak detection system indicates there may be a release or a leakage, then the owner operator of the service station is required to investigate and, if necessary, do cleanup. Now, if the owner operator cannot be located or is unwilling or financially incapable of doing it, then it defaults to the state lead unit. The release from this service station, which occurred right on the other side of those buildings over there, happened in the early 1990s, and it was a gasoline release into the water table. And some of the components of gasoline are called volatile organic constituents, which are tend to be very volatile and they're toxic. And they have the potential for migrating to the surface and impacting air quality.
The first thing that we do is we advance a 5-foot section of rod into the ground, and then after the rod is advanced into the ground, we have an expendable point on the end of our tip that is, after the rod's driven into the ground, it's pulled back and this vapor tip remains down in the soil, and that exposes this part of the tip to the soil that's down on the ground. And then after that's advanced, we lower a piece of tubing, you can see the top of the rod there, and it's threaded in place with a little stainless steel connector right here. And that's threaded down inside, and then it's reverse threaded. That seals off the inside of the rod and allows us to collect the vapor. And now we're letting the soil equilibrate for 20 minutes. And we do this as per state protocol, because when the rod is pushed into the soil, it can disrupt the vapors in the subsurface and allow them to migrate away from the rod. So we wait 20 minutes to allow those vapors to come back closer to the rod. And then in 20 minutes, we'll purge that line right there with a photoionization detector. And then we'll collect a soil gas sample in a simulator. We've used a photoionization detector. This is a small detector that pre-screens the sample before it's collected into this camp. So we purge the line for approximately 20 seconds. That gives us a general indication or reading of what the vapor concentrations might be. And then after we purge the line, then we hook up an evacuated Summa canister. These are provided by the laboratory, and this is a stainless steel silanized can that comes pre-cleaned from the laboratory. These cans are placed in a vacuum, therefore there's 30 inches of vacuum in this can. So when we hook it up to a small flow controller right here, this slows the flow down to 200 mils a minute. So it'll take, this is a 1-liter can, it'll take approximately 5 minutes for the can to fill. When the can's filled, it'll be disconnected, capped, and then sent off and packaged to the laboratory for analysis.